Like no place on Earth, Lunar Bowl offers pure out-of-this-world fun. Their smoke-free facility has 32 lanes of premier bowling, a 2,500-square-foot arcade, private conference room with a projection screen and wireless mic system, the Blue Moon Lounge featuring a full-service bar, custom catering for groups of 25 to 300, state-of-the-art sound system, and a 150-inch high-def TV. Lunar Bowl can also accommodate graduation parties, class and family reunions, birthday parties, church and school group events, company events, fundraisers, and wedding receptions. Call today, 816-220-7722 to book and plan your next event. Lunar Bowl, family-friendly fun, located on Highway 7 North in Blue Springs.
Hello, Green Valley. Welcome to this week's episode of GVTV. I'm Kirsten Hill.
And I am Tori, but some people call me TJ Squeeze.
So, as you can see behind us, we are in the new and improved GVTV studio.
Yeah, and we get to be the very first anchors in all of GVTV to appear in this new studio.
Building an awesome studio like this takes a lot of hard work and money, and without all the free labor and generous donations, none of this would have been possible.
So, GVTV would like to shout out to Sonic McDonald's Green Valley Tax Service, Dave Sneeder, Austin Walters, Mandy and Alan McElwain, Madeline and Leanne Klepper, and Jerry Vaughn and with Green Valley Education's Foundation.
So thank you guys for helping out GVTV. You are greatly appreciated by all of Green Valley.
But I am by far the most thankful of everyone. GVTV is my favorite class, and to think that I almost didn't get in and put on the schedule.
You know, even if you don't get into class, you can still be a part of GVTV. We have an Eagle Media Club after school on Wednesdays.
What? Well, I need to show everyone how awesome GVTV is. I'll be right back.
Wait, Tori.
This thing on?
Hi, so I'm here with GVTV, Team 6. Before we go see a little bit more of GVTV behind the scenes, I would like to ask you guys a quick question. I'd like to ask you a quick question. Hi, Team 6. what's your guys' favorite thing about GVTV?
Tori, I'm going to ask you what your favorite part of GVTV is.
Oh. Interacting with different people, maybe, and, ooh, interviewing people. That's always fun.
And Reagan Childers.
Same here. Same here.
This is Team 7 filming sports with Meg and Todd. This is Isaiah here.
Team 2.
Editing his beautiful work. Oh. Sorry, I got lost. If you are interested in all this GVTV fun, go to Eagle Media Productions Club after school and see Ms. McElwain in room 204 for details. It's fun and we love a big family. Now I'm gonna go back to the studio.
Well, while we are waiting for Tori to get back, let's watch another little behind the scenes clip, but this time it's not about GVTV.
I'm Isaiah Akers and I'm here with Kathy Jenkins. Kathy, can you tell us a little bit about what goes into our food here at Green Valley?
Quite a lot. We prepare everything, a lot of it from scratch. We do our best to try to make everything pleasing to the eye. And the girls work very hard back here. We try to make sure that you get vegetables every day, fruit every day, because that is what the program is based around, is vegetables and fruit.
Now, is most of this influenced by Michelle Obama?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is. Yes.
Michelle Obama's Take Action plan is to reduce the percentage of obesity in today's generation. Michelle Obama pushes to put better foods in our schools. Michelle Obama pushes to get us proper servings of all our proteins, sugars, and most importantly, our fruits and vegetables.
Yeah, she's got a lot to do with it. I don't want to run out of fruits and vegetables again because it's the main part of your meal. We ask some of the kids to go back and get a vegetable or a fruit on their plate because it's cheaper to buy a whole meal than it would be to buy a la carte, and a lot of them don't realize that.
Thank you, Kathy. I'm Isaiah Akers.
I don't know what the Take Action plan is.
Neither do I, but I know her food tastes like trash.
Well, like, I know we have wheat crust now, so that's healthy.
I mean, we had good food when Bush was president.
I'm back!
Finally, did you get lost again?
Yeah, all these new hallways and classrooms can be really confusing.
You're right. The high school has really been changing, but with all the new additions to the school, we've forgotten the biggest part.
The new big classrooms!
Nope, the freshmen! This year, Green Valley High School gained the biggest class that has ever walked through our high school.
Wow, that's a lot of people I have to remember.
Well, let's head out to Morgan to get to know a few of the 300 students in the 2018 class.
Hi, I'm Morgan Kilburn, here with freshman Holden Ballinger. Holden, tell us a little bit about yourself.
In the weight room, I bench 285 and squat 400.
Alrighty, what's your favorite part about high school?
Probably all the freedom we get.
And your least favorite?
Waking up to come to school.
Alrighty, and what are you most looking forward to for this year?
Probably getting to have an opportunity to go to state for wrestling.
Awesome. Good luck to you. Could you tell us a little bit about your upperclassman crush?
Her name is Brenna Christensen.
Ooh. Alrighty. Well, thanks. Next, I'm here with freshman Sophie Johns. Sophie, tell me what you expected high school to be like.
Hard and, like, hard to find, like, where you're going.
Has it changed since then? Anything you like now?
Yeah, the teachers and the people.
Alrighty, and what is your favorite part about high school?
My friends and, like, all the people are so nice.
Good. And could you maybe tell us your upperclassman crush?
Alfie Hansen.
Alright, thank you. I'm here with freshman McKenna Smith. McKenna, tell me what your favorite part about high school is.
Meeting new people.
Alright, and do you have a least favorite part?
Some of the classes.
In the classes. Okay, so could you tell me maybe your upperclassman crush?
Maverick Alexander.
All right, well, there you have it. I'm here with freshman Nate Chapachum. Nate, could you tell me what your favorite part about high school is?
Seeing friends and new friends.
And what did you expect high school to be like?
Having fun.
And is it what you expected?
Yeah.
Alrighty, who's your upperclassman crush?
Morgan Kilburn.
Aw. Thanks, Nate.
Some days I wish I was still a freshman.
Not me. I'm glad that year is over, but I am a little sad the high school for us seniors is almost to an end.
That's why you have to make your senior year last and go to as many school activities as you can, like Eagle Media Club, or you can go on Tuesdays to theater meetings. Just go to Miss Brown's room at 2:45 on Tuesdays.
You can also make sure to attend as many Green Valley sports events as you can. Not only will you have a blast, but you'll be supporting your fellow classmates as they play some of their final high school games.
I don't like to think that way.
And maybe you're not the only one. Let's head out to our sports team to see how some of the senior athletes have felt on their senior night. Turning up the volume so we're laughing on the dial.
Freddie Hernandez here with Riley Presnell. Riley, what impact do the fans have on the way you guys play?
Just everybody coming out, cheers us on, gets us really pumped up to play better.
And what are you expecting from this soccer season?
We're going to be pretty good this year. I expect some big things and to get a bunch of wins.
And what are some reflections on Monday night's game?
We came out, played hard. We didn't do our best, but we still tried our best.
How are you going to improve from that?
We're going to come out tonight, Tuesday, and Thursday and try and get the wins over Raytown and Harrisonville.
All right, good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you, Riley.
Hi, I'm with
Tyler Barthow, Great Valley Defender.
And Tyler, who is your biggest rival this year?
Harrisonville.
Oh, and what advice do you have for some of the younger teammates this year?
Play with confidence and play to win.
Thank you, Tyler.
Freddie Hernandez here with Megan Todd. Megan, what are some of the upcoming players that stand out to you?
Carly Harris, Bailey Bunny, and Olivia Coons. They all made varsity their freshman year, and they're doing really well.
And what impact do the fans have on the way you girls play?
Everyone out there gives us a lot of motivation, and the crowd's been really good so far. So.
And what is some advice that you have for the upcoming players?
Just always communicate and stay positive, because that's what helps us win.
Thank you, Megan. Freddie Hernandez here with Coach Peterson. Coach P, how's the team looking this year?
We've had a really great start. We're 3-1 right now.
Coach Peterson, who is your biggest rival?
Always Pleasant Hill and Conference is our biggest rival.
Ah, and how do you plan to beat your biggest rival?
I think being consistent and daily hard work at practice and in our matches.
And is there any upcoming events that we need to be aware of?
Yes, we have our Dig Pink on September 30th, and the girls will be selling flowers just like last year next week for $2. So if you want to buy carnations and help donate, that would be great.
Thanks, Coach Peterson.
First off, we have Tyler Genasi. His most memorable moment in the 4 years at Green Valley was his very first soccer practice his freshman year. Coach Thompson said, bring your boots. So he brought a pair of hiking boots to practice. And from there on out, he was known as Boot on the soccer team. Next, we have senior David Mullins. His most memorable moment in the 4 years at Green Valley was when his team beat Harrisonville for the first time in school history, also beating them in penalty kicks. And last, we have Riley Presnell. His most memorable moment in the 4 years at Green Valley was when his team beat Harrisonville in penalty kicks to win conference.
For the sports section today.
We're getting ready to go out to the fields for a Dinger Derby with Jake and Packer.
But before we go, here's some quick reminders.
Homecoming is around the corner. In less than a month, on September 27th, the annual homecoming parade will take place.
Then shortly after, Friday, October 3rd, we will win our homecoming game and then head to the dance the next day on October 4th.
Oh, and Life Direction is selling temporary eagle eye tattoos. They're only $2, so make sure to buy one and show your spirit to all the games.
Now let's check in with Jake and Packer for the Dinger Derby.
Welcome back, Green Valley High School. I'm Jake.
And I'm Packer.
And we're going to do the Dinger Derby.
If you don't know what that is, we're just going to hit some dingers.
The rules are simple. All you got to do is hit a dinger, run the bases, and don't forget to yell out a catchphrase after every hit.
Jello Beats, holla at me.
Ty Wells. Lanyard. Gibson. Served that one up, didn't you, Packer? Chocolate milk.
dinger. Well, Green Valley High School, today in the Dinger Derby, Packer won, so Kirk Gibson.
Reminder, kids, don't ever bunt.
Never.
Never say never.
Tori!
Sorry.
You're fine. I just prefer, do you want to build a snowman?
Doesn't have to be a snowman. I love Disney movies.
Well, we have a special segment brought to us today, and it's all about movies. Let's check it out.
Jasmine here from GVTV. Now let's go find out if our GVHS Eagles know their movie quotes.
Terminator.
Harry Potter?
Some people worth melting for. Sounds like it'd be a Disney movie. I'm gonna guess Frozen, but I've never actually seen it.
Napoleon Dynamite.
Karate Kid?
Mean Girls.
Apollo 11, yeah!
Star Wars?
Wonderful Wizard of Oz?
E.T.
Is it Star Wars?
Mean Girls? Mean Girls. No.
That's Scarface. No, it's not. Yes, it is. Yeah.
Those were some really good tries. Now back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Jasmine. I don't know about you, but I want to watch a movie now.
Well, it isn't a movie, but Kyle and Cooper have put a skit together to help us realize what awesome teachers we have. Let's check it out.
My name is Corey, and I'm here with GVTV. Here at Green Valley, we have a wonderful staff. But do you ever want to just like to have bad teachers? Well, today we're going to see what our teachers here at Green Valley would never do.
All right, class, is everyone here? Are you late?
Yes.
Sit down. Now go to the office.
Oh, whatever you want, Mr. Childers.
That'll be, sir.
My life as a young thug.
Hey, he's trying to sleep over here, okay? I don't want to disturb him because he needs his sleep, okay? School's not important. It's just he needs his rest, okay? All right, thank you.
Class, I think that in the piece My Life as a Young Thug, we can all take out that Mike Tyson was indeed a young thug. Did you hear that? Class, keep it down. We're trying to learn. Be good. Excuse me? I said behave. If you're gonna do it, you gotta do it right. Get on the table.
Wow, after seeing that, it makes me really appreciate the staff here we have at Green Valley. Now back to you guys in the studio.
Well, now you guys know to be a little bit more appreciative of your teachers. Maybe give them a flower every once in a while. The volleyball players will be selling them next week.
You know, some of the greatest teachers of all were our elementary teachers.
I think that Ryan is out visiting the elementary right now.
Well then, let's check in with Ryan and see what he's up to.
All right, we're here at Snybar Elementary, and we're about to see how popular GVTV is.
They know better. They know better. No flex zone. No flex zone.
Hey, I'm here with Owen. And Owen, we're wondering if you've ever seen GVTV.
Yes.
When's the last episode you've seen?
Last year.
Last year. And what's your favorite topic?
Football.
Football. So would you like to see more of the sports section?
Yes.
Okay. And would you like to give any shout-outs to your favorite teachers?
My teacher, Mrs. Little.
I'm here with my lovely aunt, Kiki Clappin. And Kiki, we were wondering the last time you saw GVTV.
I saw it last week.
So what was your favorite topic?
Then I really loved the student, the game show of the students.
Oh, by Cameron Porter?
Yes, and the crew that was with her, Tori Squires and Maverick Alexander.
Oh, that's awesome. So what would you like to see on the next GVTV?
I would like to see how the Talon does the Bachelor and Bachelor of the Month. I think something like that would be fun on GVTV, like just a personal insight into somebody who's outstanding.
Awesome. Thank you very much, Kiki.
You're welcome.
I'm here with some kids who have never seen GVTV, and this is their first time appearance. So, guys, would you ever like to see GVTV?
Yeah.
All right, we'll check in every Friday, and now...
Back to the youth studio.
Thank you, guys.
Those kiddos look like future GVTV reporters to me.
Someday they'll be sitting in these seats, and we'll be back home watching them on TV.
Well, that's all for today's episode. Make sure to like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter at GVHS Eagle Media.
See you next Friday.